This is a quick video on how to draw a motion map, which, like the title implies, is a way of representing motion. There are very specific rules to drawing one that we're going to go over. The first step in drawing a motion map is to decide on a zero point and then draw an arrow to represent the positive direction. Both of these are entirely arbitrary. You can choose any point you want to be the zero point. In general, that's just a common point where we measure other positions from. So if you're 2 meters in the positive direction away from the zero point, we would say you're at a position of positive 2 meters. Totally arbitrary, so you get to decide where that is. On the motion map, it's going to look something like this. We're going to draw a point and say that this is the zero point, and then draw an arrow coming out of it and indicate that that is the positive direction. So if an object is moving in the opposite direction of the arrow, it's moving in the negative direction. So I can now give you an example of drawing a motion map itself. What a motion map does is it puts dots at the position that an object is at after different amounts of time has passed. Usually there's one dot for every second of time. So for example, if we had a car starting at the zero point here, and the car started to move, I would put a point where the car is for every second that the car had traveled, like this. So I'm going to put a point where it starts, and then as it moves forward, I'm going to add a point for every second that it's traveled. So we don't actually represent the physical car on the motion map. This is what your motion map is going to look like when you actually draw it. No matter what object you're drawing, you're just going to draw points representing its position at different amounts of time. And you can see that the exact position is kind of arbitrary. Motion maps aren't always used very specifically. Sometimes it's just a general picture of what an object is doing. The next thing to do is to label these points with the time that it was when we drew them. So this is what that would look like. Before time had started, that was the first point, and then time is equal to 1 second, 2 seconds, 3 seconds, and 4 seconds. So the dots show where the object was after each second passed. The next thing to do is draw arrows connecting each dot from where the object started to where it stopped. The reason why we draw these arrows is because the arrows show the size of the velocity. Because velocity is displacement divided by time, and time is just 1 second for each dot, an arrow that shows the length of each interval also shows the size of the velocity. So if there's a larger distance between two dots, that means that in that 1 second you are going faster, because the same amount of time passed, but you crossed a larger distance. So the arrows are a useful way of representing how fast you are going on the motion map. So fast objects cover more distance in the same amount of time, and their velocity vectors are larger. So we can compare a faster car and a slower car like this. And you can see that if I draw a dot for every 1 second that passes, the faster car has larger arrows than the slower car, because the slower car was covering less distance, so the dots are going to be closer together. If an object is standing still, like if we have a cow sitting here and it's just standing still, we just draw the same dot every second, and we're just going to put that dot above the previous dot like this, just so we don't keep drawing in the same place over and over again. So if you have dots that are kind of piling on each other like this, what this means is that the object is standing still in one specific spot. To show an object moving in the negative direction, we just have it move in the opposite direction of your positive direction. So this is an example of the car moving in the negative direction. And you could also draw arrows pointing to the left to connect those dots. We draw a double arrow above the first arrow to show the acceleration of the object. These arrows show how much the velocity increases or decreases in 1 second, the definition of acceleration. With every second, the velocity arrow will get one acceleration arrow length larger or smaller. So I'll show you an example. Let's say that at time equals zero, there's no velocity, but there is an acceleration arrow. So this acceleration arrow is showing you how much faster you'll be going after 1 second. So it's going to show you the increase in the velocity arrow in 1 second. So after 1 second, the velocity is going to be the acceleration arrow plus zero, because there's no velocity to start off here. So it's just the acceleration arrow's length. And then after 2 seconds, the velocity arrow is going to be the acceleration arrow bigger than it was before, like this. So the acceleration arrow is showing you how much the velocity arrow is growing over time. So we can do that again. We're assuming that the acceleration is just staying constant here, which it always does. It's very rare to get a changing acceleration. So we connect that arrow and see that it's getting bigger and bigger and bigger. So you can see that we can use these acceleration arrows to show you how much faster the object is getting per second. If the acceleration arrow is pointing in the opposite direction of the velocity, like I'm imagining that this is starting with a very large positive velocity, if it's pointing in the opposite direction, that means that the acceleration is actually slowing the object down. It's getting slower over time. So if I combine the acceleration arrow with the velocity arrow like this, you can see that it's pushing back against it, and so the new velocity will be smaller than before, and it keeps pushing back against it, so it becomes smaller and smaller and smaller. So acceleration arrows pointing in the opposite direction show you how the velocity is getting smaller over time by that exact amount. And that's everything that you have to know about drawing a motion map.